You always very vehemently write about women's issues, women's oppression and all. You might have heard about this matrilineal system which was very rampant in Kerala.
Yeah, it was very, yeah.
Do you think we as Kerala women, we used to get a more prestigious position in the society and family. Do you think this matrilineal system could be an answer to women's oppression and all?
In many ways, yes. And in fact, actually, Kerala was the last surviving matrilineal system. There were matrilineal systems across India in ancient times. And not just matrilineal, there were matriarchal systems as well. But in some of those matriarchal systems, the issue was more about rights for men. So look, the thing that I keep speaking repeatedly on, is that perhaps a mistake that many liberals make in India is that they keep quoting Western examples, and that is not going to work. Because what that does is gets many Indians to get irritated, right? Why can't we quote our own examples? Examples linked to our own soil, linked to our own roots. So if we are talking about, women's rights, to not just read, but to write scriptures, quote the examples of Maharishika Maitre, Maharishika Indrani from the Vedic age. If we are talking about the, the rights of women to rule, to run a state, run a country, why can't we quote the examples of the Bhopal Begums, for example? Part of my family lived in Bhopal, therefore I know. Sadly, most people in India don't know. There was a amazing line of queens, of Begums in Bhopal. And the royal line used to pass from the mother to the daughter. Okay? They were Muslim women, Muslim Begums. Why can't we quote these examples rather than quoting some American or British example, which most Indian will say, boss, what's it to me, man? Yeah. Correct? Why can't we quote the example of Rudrama Devi? Why can't, like Adi Shankaracharya ji, one of the greatest debates that he had was with Mandanamon in Ujjain. Anyone knows who was the judge of that debate? It was one of the greatest debates in history, And I'm sure you know that the judge can only be the judge when he or she has more knowledge than even the people debating.
Exactly.
So imagine this was a debate in which Adi Shankaracharya ji himself was taking part. Who was the judge? Does anyone know? Who's the judge, sir? Right, sir. Ubhay Bharti, applause for him. The judge of that debate was Ubhaya Bharti, a woman. Now, none of this is taught to us in our schools. So many of us, many Indians who get educated assume that our culture is about oppressing women. Nonsense. Our ancient culture is the exact opposite of that.
Okay.
But we need to quote these examples. And it's not just about, because it's the moral or the dharmic thing to do. Because it will be a better society when men and women are equal. It's also the patriotic things to do. How can our country develop if 50% of India is oppressed?